Even before there was this book about God, there was that book about God. The one just outside those windows, of which we are part and parcel. And on this Earth Day, this is about that. What's outside those windows is the earth, and more actually, all the universe, all creation. One thing we know about that world is that all creatures relate. All creatures influence each other and their environment. The interrelatedness of the earth exists within the interrelatedness of all the cosmos. Religion is about relationship. It's about this relatedness. The Latin root of the word religion is ligare. It means to connect. Ligare is also the root of the word ligament. Ligare, religion. It's about connection. It will always ask the question, to whom or to what are we connected? It's always going to be about connecting with God, about connecting with each other, our neighbor, and with all of creation. All this interconnectedness has got to be grounded in creation. That's why, if we get too far from nature, we run the risk of losing something of our souls. We know, too, that this interrelatedness is marked by a dynamic process called evolution. Catholic Christianity is a religion of evolution. And we know evolution is a movement from simple to more complex life forms. And we know that evolution is ultimately a progression towards consciousness. The material world contains within it a dynamism towards spirit. Life prefers increased life. And the human person, you and I, we are integrally part of evolution in that we too rise from the process. We are born of this process of evolution, you and I, and all the human family. But in reflecting on the process, we also stand apart from it. Teilhard de Chardin, a Jesuit priest, scientist, paleontologist, wrote that the human person is nothing more than evolution become conscious of itself. There are many critical moments along the way. Matter becoming conscious was one of those critical moments. Another was Christ, the Christ event. Christ is not simply some object to be adored or worshipped. Christ is not some intrusion into an otherwise evolutionary universe, nor is belief in Christ just some sort of therapeutic remedy for our sins. Rather, Christ is the core of evolution itself. Christ is the very core of evolution. This unfolding universe is the coming of Christ, not from without, but from within. The dynamism at the heart of matter is Christ. For us believers, evolution is not some blind or random process, but one with some direction oriented towards this Christ Omega, this fullness of Christ. This Christ Omega, this fullness of love, is the unifying influence in the whole of the evolutionary process, holding the entire process together and moving it forward. The process of evolution is the coming to be of Christ. Its end, the fulfillment of all evolution, is the Christ. And this Christ is found present now in the entire cosmos. From the least particle of matter to the convergence of the entire human community. Like yeast in the dough, Christ is. The world is like a crystal lamp, illumined from within by the light of Christ. Christ shines in this diaphanous universe. Nature is bright with Christ. In the gospel tonight, you heard how those who love Jesus struggled to understand their experience of him after his death, struggled to understand how he was still the same, and yet a whole new way of being in this universe. After his death, he was as specific as breakfast and as big as the cosmos. This risen Christ, no longer bound by space, no longer bound by time. This is what we know of this risen body. Christ invests himself organically in all of creation, immersing himself in things, in the heart of matter, and thus unifying the world. Everything, therefore, is Christified. That's how Teilhard de Chardin described this process. Everything. Christified, made Christ. The whole evolutionary suite recapitulated in the person of Jesus, right there. And it's all sacramentalized in the Eucharistic bread and wine. Teilhard de Chardin wrote, and I quote, as our Holy Father has himself recently, "The effect of the priestly act extends beyond the consecrated host to the cosmos itself. The entire realm of matter is slowly but irresistibly affected by this single consecration. Christ's transforming activity must move from the church's altar to the altar of the material universe. In other words, in the act of consecration, the inwardness of bread and wine, the Christ that burns there on the inside, moves to the outside and becomes the thing. And what happens here is what's happening in the entire universe. The inside turns out. What Father Teilhard de Chardin is saying to all of us who have the ears to hear is that what happened after Jesus' death, their experience of him and their struggle to put it into words, invites us to something. It invites us to broaden our understanding of this Christ, not to abandon what we profess or proclaim, but to allow these beliefs to open us to a world of evolution of which we are vital members. It invites us to participate in this process of the coming to be of Christ. It invites us to risk getting involved in creation and invites us to aim towards union with others along the way, to immerse ourselves in the world, plunging our hands into the soil of their earth and touching the roots of life. It invites us to leave the cities here and there every once in a while and return along the way to the wilderness. It invites us to be attentive to the most ordinary things, to re-engage community and to disengage from cyber artificiality. And finally, it invites us to listen to the cry of the earth, to listen to the cry of the entire cosmos, because it's crying Christ. The world is charged with the grandeur of God, and we are called to see deeply into the reality of things. The smallest things of creation, like a leaf or a grain of sand or a shooting star, it's all charged now with divine meaning, and it's of infinite value. Without such attention, we lose contact with Christ and his most widely extended body of creation. The evolution of Christ's body continues in us. This is our common task, my friends, to move evolution forward by harnessing the energies of love toward this Christ Omega, towards the fullness. On this Earth Day night, in the name of the whole church, thank you. Thank you to you who are studying science and biology and chemistry and engineering, and geology, and astronomy, and mathematics, and physics. Thank you for the hard work you do, and all you others who in your work are teaching us how to read. And to reading that book about God. leave you tonight with the bold words of St. Bonaventure. Bold because they carry a warning. And I quote, "Therefore, any person who is not illumined by such great splendor in created things is blind. Anyone who is not awakened by such great outcries is deaf. Anyone who is not led by such effects to give praise to God is mute. Anyone who does not turn to the first principle as a result of such great signs is a fool. Therefore, open your eyes, alert your ears, unlock your lips, apply your heart, so that in all creatures you may see, hear, praise, love, adore, magnify, and honor your God, lest the entire world rise up against you." The words of our Father, Bonaventure.